They are quick. Again, no pun intended. Damn it.
You're trying.
Trying to take control now towards the A tower, and it's a late split for Loud as well. You see both Les and Kowenzine holding passively towards the A main. See no pressure. They can once again take control of A Heaven. And then maintaining A Heaven control has been in the end of the game on this very map, in this meta. Still a player holding towards the back of the site though. Zelsis is hiding behind the map through two cages, through an orb. A snake bite gives his position away, trying to look for a trap through this trip. But it's Kowenzine that breaks it, runs through, and scores first. A one for one though, as Tenz is low on HP. Spike finally going down. Asasi is on that flank on the A main. Les has fallen, so the control on the A Heaven is going to be a little bit more difficult, especially when two is low.
So, the 4v2. Throw your one, and that's. So Sandal's gonna Loud is gonna go walk up through A, and Sassy just gets into cover. He doesn't know about that, I guess. He's gonna hard flank him. Oh. That was so good. So, John knows where he's coming from.
Very strong defensive halves on this map. Toxin screen down. So now they have to try to work something. Getting a flat maybe would have helped them a little bit more in the further round. But at least they still have a gun round now. Third round on the board. More split, but Tenz long range with a stinger. Laser beams QZK. Wow. Allows Sentinels to get the power play.
They're still going to be. I was going to say, that's a trap play to mid, but it really only needed the smoke to drop and Tenz to be there. They were all ready to back them up.
So Sentinels have the man advantage. Where is Drew?
Before they get to the site, get this utility out of their hands because the retake is just too strong. They ramp control here for Loud. Just try and pressure, try and get Sentinels to move. This allows them from the original starting spots. And coming up from the vent, could get a kill here. On to Zelsis. Perfect cross, Zelsis goes back up. There's the smoke from the high behind the bike of wall.
Oh my god. Bro.
Crazy
But it was an expensive round, I would say. Probably they're gonna execute B. They got two posted on A and one coming through sewers. Going A, I guess. Bro.
Trying to go.
So, QCK is ramp controls. Okay. Oh, that's sad. So they have info that there is nobody roughed us. Oh, that's good. How did he get two? Oh, that's... Celsius is his rotation, right?
Thank you.
their way in, watching just the entrance to sight from the top side here.
But that boom bot gives a clue here. Oh, that player's coming across the wall, bang after. But the second one is lower to the ground.
Vansili?
They're sticking a spike right now, and Celsius will get the defuse.
Sunset had Loud, that's for sure. I feel like there's a moment of pressure there for Loud too in that 2v2. Ouch.
Ouch.
So it's a beautiful call.
What?
Pushing up, finding their own fights, pushing Loud out of their own strategies constantly. Here to reset, try again. Less mechanically gifted, ready to open up on any members that peak, but Sentinels stay hunkered down, trading each other and ready on these hard angles. Even all the way out of A. At this point, usually you have members anchored in sight, but they're not giving Loud any opportunities.
Exactly. You got active information. The camera's watching everything from A to all towards heaven. They just flashed towards the garage as well, coming out from Sasi. Now, the only positions that they can think of is mid, vents, or rotate back towards A main, holding outside of the radius of that camera. It's not going to be easy for Loud to take position, so you already see it still anchoring up now towards the middle.
Yeah, this
or
is
giving
a
up
save.
This round, yeah.
Save for sure, knowing the ultimates are there. Zekin could easily just pop in. It seems like he has alts on rerun right now. More in his pocket once he uses it.
Sorry, gives me an opportunity to talk a little bit about that pressure I was talking about. And falling on those slight mistakes, it was a 2v2 with a boom bot outside of their own pit to get their position.
Yeah. All right.
So Loud is pushing, hard pushing B right now, and Sarak is looking. Oh, that's really good.
Less is out towards the pillar, gets a pick. Look at that TV for the whole time as well. Things are looking good here for Loud on the post plan. High low stack now towards the dumpster. Paranoia and Flash coming through. The high low is good for that first pick. Ken's looking to create a back, looking left and right through the
old. Oh my god. Oh wow.
And it looks beautiful as a rotate for Loud. They're looking for a pressure towards middle as well. And you mentioned two lurkers on central side. John Cootie punishing that push from Loud. Already a 5-on-3. As the Sattel comes in and we'll have a secure plant for Sentinels in the second pistol split.
Ooh, tough entry there. You'll get Sadak back over. No utility to get back in this one. So it's just going to be the three members to help with a fall fine.
Yeah.
Five of Sentinel. So a quick take by Sen with a little bit of pressure around the map, knowing what rotations might be coming through and just playing this wall a little bit.
And that small pressure that you mentioned, towards that B side,
yeah,
kept Sadak the whole round pretty much
to break.
Took a couple of seconds before he actually rotated back with the rest of the team to move in this A side for the attempt of a retake that will get full denied by Sentinels, only losing Saucy in the process.
Yeah, not get the start. Two some of these angles right on top of Sentinels. They're going to work the wall still with a bit of hesitation on the left side of the map to see if Loud wants to push.
Making it out?
Yeah, that's going to be one of their big things coming into the gun round, if Loud cannot get extremity control.
And this is where you start understanding the play style of Loud. Four buys that they have, they usually have shotguns to work with. This time, two buckies for Kalazin and Sadat. So as soon as the fall line came out, instant wall, instant camera, just to try to spot players running through. Naz, nothing really happens. They're playing around this map, around the A site. And really kind of leaves Kalazin pinned here in this position. So then the pressure comes back towards Les. The trailers are now spots Kalazin. He goes for another fall line, but long range.
Oh my god. If QT gets home. Oh my god. Bro, how?
Lurks on these off these both plants. Probably
So that's two maps. And the next one is Icebox, which Sadak plays Masterclass. And thing is that Sentinels don't have that much experience playing Icebox.